I've had a number of people contact me about the LibreOffice 4.4 sidebar, either asking my opinion or asking me to do a tutorial about it. To see the sidebar, you need to be using LibreOffice 4.4 or higher. To know what version you're using, go into Help, About LibreOffice. We see I'm using 4.4.1.2. And over here on the right is the new sidebar. If you don't see it, you can go into View and see if it is down here and has a check mark next to it. This means it's showing. Clicking that turns it off. Clicking it again turns it back on. If I click on one of the tools, opens it up and closes it. If I open it up and grab the title bar, I can move it so it is floating, or I can dock it on the other side. I cannot dock it to the top or bottom like I can a toolbar. Over about halfway up on the inside, since I've got this docked to the left side, the dots are on the right side, and it says hide. If I click that, it hides it. Clicking that again will show this. And I can also stretch it out a little bit to give it more or less room. Up at the top, we've got the control properties. Clicking that shows us the control properties of the sidebar. We see we've got properties, styles and formatting, gallery, and navigator. Those are the four icons showing. Down below that, we can undock this, which we already did just by grabbing the title bar. We can close the sidebar. To open it again, we need to go into View. And from here, we can click on the sidebar, opening it back up. Then at the bottom, we've got customization. It looks like we've got a bullet by the properties because we've got that one selected, but we can turn off any of the other three. If I click on the navigator, it is now not showing in the sidebar. I'm going to click on the gallery. Now I'm going to go back up to the control properties. We see the gallery now has the bullet, and in the customization, we cannot turn off the gallery, but we can turn off the properties or styles and formatting. So at least one of these has to be open at all times. I'm going to restore the sidebar to the default. And let's go up to the top one, properties. It's pretty obvious what these are. You've got the character set, which we see right here in the formatting toolbar. Then we've got our paragraph controls, which are also in the formatting toolbar. But down at the bottom, we've got some page shortcuts too. Things like the page orientation and margin. And then we can show and hide these by clicking on the triangles. And if I don't see the function here available, I can click on the More Options, which opens up the complete list of tools that we can use. Let's go down into the Styles and Formatting. To see what this is doing better, I am going to open up a file that I had downloaded from the website from my Writer tutorial series. And here we see we've got the default style, same as we see in our formatting toolbar. And if I click down here on this introduction, we see that it changes to my heading, which is also the same thing that we see in the formatting toolbar. If I click into the paragraph, we're now looking at the paragraph style, my paragraph, which is under the default style. And this is the standard styles and formatting toolbar. From here, we can fill the format mode and create new styles. Let's take a look at the gallery. We've got the icon view or detail view. They've added in a lot more clip art to help us out if we're doing a report or presentation. And down here at the navigator, you can see under the headings that if I want to go to any one of my headings, just double clicking on it takes me right there to that heading. The same thing with the images. If I click on the image, it takes me right up to the image. If I had bookmarks, I could also find those quickly and easily. So I am quite pleased with the sidebar for LibreOffice Writer. Let's take a look at the sidebar for LibreOffice Calc. New spreadsheet. And it's over here on the right. We've got the properties, which all look pretty similar. And then we've got the more options, styles and formatting, that works the same. The gallery's the same. Navigator's pretty similar. They also have this thing for functions. And this shows the last used. I don't have a way to clear that out, but it is kind of handy if you use the same functions often enough. Then you can also come down to all, database, dates and time, logical, that's all pretty standard. Coming back here to properties, there's one thing that I did not see on here that I would like to see, and that is the conditional formatting. Because it's not on here, I need to keep this formatting toolbar open just for our conditional formatting condition. I like that one click to open that up. But we don't have this on the sidebar anywhere. So that's one improvement that I'd like to see, or a way to add or remove my own functions to the sidebar. And maybe that option is available, but I just don't know where it is. Let's go into one more. I want to go into File, New, Drawing. If we open up the properties here, we don't see anything. That's because we need to add an object onto the page to see the properties. I'll put in a rectangle, and we see the character, paragraph, area, line, and position and size. Now if I come down to text and add a text document, we only have character and paragraph. But if I click on the border of the text, it brings me the character, paragraph, area, line, and position and size. So depending on which part I'm working with, we have different properties. Looking at the styles work pretty much the same. We can add in some clip art from the gallery, and we've got the navigator. Overall, I do like the new sidebar, although for LibreOffice Calc, I do think they need to add in the conditional formatting to that sidebar.